one.
It's amazing that you can remember one.
Oh, they're all different, you see. That one's there, mummy. They're all different, you see.
That's stalk.
They're all different.
What about this little brindle one over here?
Nelson.
What about him making all the noise?
Go back.
They're desperate to get out, aren't they?
Oh, aye. They're eager.
A crisp December morning on the Yorkshire Moors, and a sport new to me, beagling.
Come on, hold in here. Come along, deadly. Come on. Come on now.
These little hounds hunt hares. They're the Home Valley Beagles, one of 87 packs in this country. The huntsman and raider's the boss, and we follow him with the hounds raring to go.
Come on now, stay back.
The lads in green are the whippers in, available for assistance when needed. Keeping me right today is Cyril Ford, the master of the Home Valley Beagles.
Oh, you're the master, he's the huntsman. He would just hunt on like that.
That's it. Yeah, he'll go at this pace now until we find here.
And then when we lift one, we're off like hell.
You're off as fast as you can bloody go, then. It's up to you, as long as you don't get it from the hounds.
Oh, I'm not getting from the hounds, but I doubt if I'll be able to keep up with them.
Oh, you won't. No. It's impossible.
What about rabbits? Do you get any problems with rabbits?
They'll go on rabbits, but we stop them on rabbits. The old hounds, they won't. It's the young ones. They're gone, but they learn.
I must say, they're a lovely sight, seeing all them.
Oh, yeah. See, another thing about them as well. People see this, and they think they aren't disciplined. That they're savage and things like that. But these, you see, they're bred to do a job, and this is part of the job that they're bred to do. They're bred to find hares and to hunt them, and to hunt them fair. Actually, the art of the job is not to catch hares, just to hunt them, and to hunt them fair. We breed a hound which will cover our country, the stone walls, the grouse moors, and things like that, to hunt the line of the hare.
Well, obviously you have to kill them. You have to kill a hare occasionally, otherwise they wouldn't be as keen.
Oh yeah, occasionally we do catch them, but we don't breed a hound specifically to kill hares. If we wanted to kill hares, we could breed hounds big enough
to catch them.
To catch them.
Yeah. So these are really little hounds that are designed to hunt hares and give people pleasure of following it, a bit of fresh air out in the countryside for the day, and see a good chase.
That's it. Yeah. That's it in a nutshell.
Good, well, shall we go and catch up with them?
Yep. Are you going across the road, John? Go on.
They are a bit on the small side when you get up to them. I didn't realise. They look a lot bigger with the distance than you. But they are pretty.
Yeah. Oh, aye. And these, as far as beetles are concerned, these are big compared to some beetles. Yeah. Hold.
Hounds have hunted out every square foot of every field the huntsman has taken him through. But not a sound out of them yet. You wonder whether it's a lack of scent or a lack of hares. Still, it doesn't matter. It's a grand day to be out on the hill.
Well, I would have thought, Cyril, this would have been a perfect day for scenting. I mean, you've got a slight breeze, not too much, a little bit of dampness in the air.
Well, yeah, it is. It perhaps looks a perfect day for walking and things like that. But scent is a very queer commodity. You can't tell until we start actually hunting whether it's going to be a good scenting day, fair scenting day, or there's no scent. The only time, really, when you can tell that there's not going to be any scent at all is when there's a haze, when you see a blue haze. Have you ever seen it?
Aye.
When you see that blue haze, then you can guarantee that there's no scent. That's the only time. But until we find something to hunt and hunt it...
You'll not know.
You can't tell, no.
And then you'll tell by the hounds and the way they pack up tight, on the same line.
You can tell them with the performance of the hounds, how they work, and how they work the line out, and the speed they go at. Because they only go as fast as the nose will allow them.
Well, they might be off over the hill as soon as they see you coming.
We see now, if ones had gone out of this field in the last 10 minutes, quarter of an hour, if there's a fair scent, hounds will hunt that line, and they'll hunt up to it.
So it doesn't matter that the hare's gone?
Oh, no.
If they put a hare up down here, Cyril, it would be a brown hare?
Yes.
Do you get any blue ones?
Yes, well, not down here, but up in the far hills there, we get brown here, blue ones up there. And they
what do you prefer to hunt?
Oh, brown ones. Oh, brown here. Brown here, a good brown here, is beautiful to watch, and it's a marvellous animal.
Oh, I love hares myself. Oh,
yes, terrific. They're
a lot of character.
Character, the speed, they're clean, they're spotless, they're very good. Oh, they're a marvellous animal. I should imagine it's one of the best animals, well, I think, that we have in this country.
I think a lot of people would agree with you.
Yeah, they're beautiful. And just to see their antics, even when you're hunting them, it's unbelievable. You know, I've seen hares being hunted and stop 200 or 300 yards in front of the pack, and pack's hunting up to them, and I've seen them sit there, crouch, and start preening themselves. And then they've pricked their ears up, hounds come in, and they're off again.
Off again.
Yeah. We've got 16 couple here today, and every one of them hounds has hunting that line. And they're all eager, they're all there, they're all wanting to speak, and they won't speak until they've touched it. But once they do, they speak, and other hounds come in there, and just
certainly that's when the adrenaline starts to run a little bit.
That's when the adrenaline starts,
There she is. We're off.
It's not flat out all the time, because the hare jinks and turns, and then the hounds overrun it and lose the scent. Then they have to cast around and try and pick the trail up again. And at least that gives you a chance to catch up.
Is it the same hare? It's very hard to tell. It's certainly taking us back round the hill again, which is what hunted hares tend to do, running wide circles round their home country. There's only one hound still hot on the trail, but if he sings out loud enough, he'll soon be joined by the others.
Right to corner again.
We're going to cut up the fence.
I'm going over here.
Well, a long way behind the hare. I mean, you went through that top of that field, what, 5 minutes ago?
Oh, I got 5 minutes since, yeah.
I can see why you're hunting for 2 hours.
That's it, you see, yeah?
I don't know what I've been about for an hour there, and I'm beginning to feel it.
Yeah.
I think we may cut a few corners now, eh?
Aye, I think we better. Haven't you been doing anything before? Let's go. Let's walk up there. Let's come up, let's go up there.
Not enough corners.
No one can keep up with a hunting pack of beagles. Even when they seem to have slowed down, it's only because they're running on the spot. They just never stop, and yet they must cover 20 to 30 miles on a deer's hunt. You've got to know the local countryside for this game, and then you can cut some corners and hope to keep in touch.
Well, we fight the blasted things.
This is it, isn't it? That's what it's all about. If you get so far behind like we have...
Now, that's some people here, so it must be there.
Ah, some followers here, so...
There's a couple there. I think they must have gone over the road again.
Yeah, must have, yeah.
Oh, they're down the bottom there, look.
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's really that.
Where's it gone? Have you seen it?
They're all there, are they?
Yes, I know. They've
come to all up more. One or two about, didn't they?
What's your travelling and beagling in him? Why is it better than, say, fox hunting? What's the difference?
Well, you keep him more in view all the time. When a fox gets up, it's away. Here they go, you know, they don't turn, same as a hare. When you get the hare up, it comes round, round, and again. You can watch it an hour, you know.
So you've been stood in this nice, comfortable position, and you've watched all the hunting go on over there, which we've been doing all day.
That's correct.
Every hare we've lifted has come back through this valley.
There and down this road here. They've been coming down this road while I've been stood up there. That's theirs. Just one hound with it, you know, and they've brought them down while you've been over there.
You see a hound's working more. You see the hounds working most of the time, according to the type of the country that you're hunting in, of course. If it's very hilly, and they're round the other side of the hill, of course, you've got to get round. But if it's similar country to this, you can see them most of the time.
Is this good country for beagling?
Oh, yes. You see, the idea of hunting, contrary to what a lot of people think that don't do any, it's watching your hounds work.
We've chased hares all over the place. I haven't caught one yet.
No, well, that isn't the thing, is it, really? You aren't interested in catching, it's the hunting part.
They're going up there, look.
we'll let you join for a year for a fiver.
And what do I get for that?
Well, you can come hunting every week and we cap for a pound every meet.
Well, what days do you hunt, though?
Saturday and Tuesdays, well, mainly.
Can I get it half price, because I can only come Tuesdays?
Oh, no, we don't have half-day closing.
Go on in. Seeing as I promised you a fiver, I'll put it in my pocket, actually. There's me.
Well, there's an appointment card, so you'll know the places where we're going to meet, okay, and the turnout times and how often it is.
And you'll send me a membership card as
yes,
well?
Yes, I'll send you a membership card and your receipt for your money, like, okay, and you're all right for 12 months then.
From the sound of it, most of the hounds were at the bottom of the dale. But a few were looking a bit lost as they tried to join up with the pack. It's the Whipper Inn's job to gather these stragglers up. I was surprised by these little dogs. I'd always thought of beagles as being a bit soft and cuddly. Far from it. They're as hard as nails and they don't give up easily, even on three legs. I think there's two or three hairs in there, though.
There's two or three. Right down there. I thought they were down there.
Don't get a tripod.
There must be a lot of hairs lying in there. Mm-hmm. At 11 o'clock we'd started hunting, and now it was 3. 4 hours without a stop. Plenty of hares, maybe too many. As soon as one was lost, there was another to take its place.
Strike a lad.
Then suddenly you kill, and not even the hare that we're hunting. This one just sat still for a bit too long. The pack stumbled across it, and that was that. Anyway, the light was going now, so that was it for today. I'd enjoyed it, the exercise, the excitement. You can't say that we'd been performing any sort of public service, because really, I don't think that hares are much of a pest. And anyway, We were exercising them more than killing them. But it's hard to see what harm we had done. One hare had died violently, that's true. But then I suppose all hares die violently. Wild animals don't die in their beds of old age. And calves must kill 100 times more than are ever killed by hounds. It's strange, I know, but beaglers do care passionately about the hares. They spend the day hunting them, but come night, there they are in the pub, singing their praises.
They came that night to Borshurst, a hunting cup to fill. Said Andrew's merry gentlemen, this day we failed to kill. But as long as I be huntsman, I swear it now, said he, that the brown hare of Whitebrook shall live in peace for me, to me falder all the day, to me falder all the day. Wild dove, storm crags and battle guard that wild and lonely heath, whilst Alderman's proud headland lies o'er the dale beneath, while Ashway's moorland waters roll westward to the deep, the fame of old John Andrews, though Saddleworth Hill shall keep, to me falder alderay, to me falder alderay. Hounds are out and the morning shines clear. The woods and the fields now provide. How can you, how will you lie snoring in vain? While we all on horseback to ride, me brave boys, me brave boys, me brave boys, me brave boys. That's the beauty of all hunting, and away with them, Jack, and away with them, Jack, and away with them, Jack. That's the beauty of all hunting, and away with them, Jack, Jack, Jack.
Yes.